Well, great. We've got some upgrades. We've got some off-bright crack ties and miles of copy top. TV, deep freeze, baby Bowie open. Who goes, go, change, what's next? Let her push, never got some track suits from a bush and shut the bush.
Areas better. It's always like a kind of double-edged sword because I know for myself in Lewisham that when the artists go in, then gentrification isn't shortly coming after that. So you, as much as it's a good thing, you always feel like you're the vanguard of something horrible as well. But because the artists come in, then the developers come in, then the artists have to leave. So it's a process, really, I think, as much as anything. And it's a good and a bad process.
Well, I've had a studio here for the last 8 years, and it's really changed in that time. It used to just be artist studios. The artists who were here already, we've seen a move of people talking to the area, just really, it's often led by artists, because, you know, around artists, the sort of cafes sort of spring up, and it's kind of subculture kind of going on. Now, it's really a question of people like myself staying here and being able to stay here rather than being priced out of studios at least. So I'm here working in the city and I make paintings about landscape. So I go to landscape environments and work for my own photography. So it's interesting for me coming back and working in the city because with the multicultural nature of the city, people come into my studio and they're really coming from all sorts of backgrounds, all sorts of different histories. But I find that the landscape is a kind of unifying thing. Often people have memories of landscapes and countries where they grew up to. And my work is all about memory and reconnecting. So I find lots of interesting